Hello everyone. Today we will be discussing parasites and parasitic infections of the oral cavity. So parasites can be divided into two main groups. One is protozoa and other are helminths. Protozoa are unicellular parasites, whereas helminths are multicellular parasites. Protozoa can be further divided based on the mode of movement. One is plasmodroma, which move by the means of pseudopodia or flagella. And the other one is ciliophora, which move by the means of cilia. Diseases caused by protozoa include trypanosomiasis, leishmaniasis, trichomoniasis and toxoplasmosis. Helminths are also known as metazoa. Helminths can be divided into two types based on the shape. One is nemethelminths or roundworm. The other one is platyhelminths or flatworm. This is list of diseases caused by helminths. The important one to us in dentistry are cysticercosis and miasis. Cysticercosis, as the name suggests, is disease caused by infestation by cysticercus. Any cysticercus is larva of Tinea species. The larva of cysticercosis that affect human being is known as Cysticercus cellulus, and it is larvae of Tinea solium. Causes of cysticercosis include: 1. Is consumption of inadequate cooked pork, because pigs are intermediate host of Cysticercus larvae. 2. Is consumption of fecally contaminated vegetable, food or water. Another one is self-contamination by reflux, that is food or processed food getting regurgitated from intestine into stomach. And one more cause is contaminated hands before having food. Cysticercosis in general manifests as solitary or multiple, painless, well-circumscribed, fluctuant swellings. In oral cavity, they mainly present on lips, cheeks and tongue, and often mimic mucosal. Microscopically, they appear as fibrous capsules surrounding cysticercus. When a cyst dies spontaneously or as a result of chemotherapy, there is more inflammation. And as the time progresses, the dead parasite disintegrates and it often gets calcified within the residual fibrous scar. Another parasitic infection is oral miasis. Oral miasis is a condition in which the soft tissue of different parts of the oral cavity are invaded by the parasitic larvae of flies. Here the fly are known as diptera and its larvae are known as maggots. It is associated with poor personal hygiene. In oral miasis, the female fly infests its ova in open wound, dead tissue, or directly in the oral cavity. Other parts included are ear and nostrils. Usually, the flies will lay over 500 eggs directly in the tissue. The eggs are hatched in the tissue and they get nourishment from the soft tissue blood supply. They usually present as painful growth with ulceration and itching due to crawling movement of the larvae. The treatment is aimed at removal of the larvae from the affected area and flushing the area with normal saline and antiseptics. Okay, that's all from my side. Aspire MDS. Thank you.